Hello students.
Hello students.
You must be working hard and learning new things. Today we are going to learn one more new things so that you have greater knowledge of physics in your life. Today we are going to learn about the magnetism and the matter. Before starting this chapter, I will tell you about how we are going to learn this chapter in upcoming 40 minutes or 30 minutes lecture, and what is the purpose of this chapter. The human race is always baffled with invisible forces. Even the greatest scientist like Albert Einstein was baffled by the invisible forces. And the book gave to him by his father was main or sole purpose of his life, to find the relation of the invisible forces. Invisible forces includes, as you know, that you have read already in electromagnetism, that electricity and magnetism are two invisible forces which you study at this level. There is infinity level of invisible forces, and we also talk about all the other dimension which can be possible. That's a different thing you will going to have study in the first semester of your engineering or the second semester of engineering. That different thing. Today what we are going to study is how a thing can be called a magnet, and what is the magnetic field, and what is effect of magnetic field on the matters. So we also going to discuss a little bit about the matter, like solid matter, liquid matter and the gaseous matter. We is not going to about the plasma matter. That's the fourth stage of matter, as you know. And the effects of the magnetic field on the matter will be studied by the three main classes of the magnetic material: diamagnetic material, paramagnetic material and ferromagnetic material. After that, we are going to study about the QD temperature. What is the QD temperature and why we are going to study? And after that, we are going to study other form of classification of the magnetic material, like the domain effect, how we are going to deal with it. So let's start the chapter with the magnet. What is the magnet? So student, what is the magnet? We all of us in our life use some kind of the magnet material. Like we use old times in the 90s and 80s, we used to use radio transistor, and right now we use television, even the phone. There always a use of magnet. We always use the magnet. And in the ancient time, when the magnetism wasn't discovered, then the ore magnetite was very the unique look as of the very unique material, because that material showed or attract the some specific kind of matter which has the property like the iron or the alloy of the iron. The magnetite was going to attract all those ferro types of material. We are going to talk about it. So let's define what is the magnet. Well, magnet is basically a thing or is the material which have a magnetic field or attract certain type of material. So please write down the definition. Magnets: the ability of an object or material to produce invisible magnetic lines in order to develop a force which attracts other ferromagnetic material such as iron, steel or the alloy of iron, steel and nickel. I'm not going to tell the name because we are going to study those material separately. So what we study, that magnet is basically a material or object which is having magnetic field or attracting certain kind of object. There are two classification of calling a thing a magnet. What is the, now we are going to talk about what is the magnetic effect, magnetic field do, or what is a magnetic dipole, how the magnetic field has effect on the material. So now we are going to talk about magnetism first. What, like the characteristic shows, the phenomena shows by magnet is called the magnetism. So please write down the definition, student. Hurry up. because this chapter we are going to talk about and write down all the definition. So you should writing in the very quick speed and then understanding the things. Okay, so write the definition of magnetism. Magnetism is a phenomena by the virtue of which there develops an attracting or repulsive force between two magnet object. So first of all thing, it's not only attracting, it's also repulsive. It is common game in the childhood we play that same pole doesn't attract each other. There is a very famous proverb you must heard that similar person doesn't attract each other. You have a friend, they will have a different characteristic than you. You know, similar. The similar person doesn't feel that friendly with each other. That's, you know. So now we're going to talk about what is the magnetic field and how we are going to apply that magnetic field in our chapter. The magnetic field is the magnetic field. What we are going to study is that when we are going to move the compass near a material which is showing the attraction or repulsion to certain kind of object, that material show that one kind of lines is emerging from the one pole and going to other pole. One is will call the north pole and the second will be called south pole. But what is happening at a molecular level, everything in the matter is made of atom. An atom is made of a nucleus and electrons. So what is happening inside the atom? Now we're going to get a reason why there is a magnetism, or what is the main cause of the magnetism. The motion of electron, like we already studied in the atomic structure, or you're going to study in the atomic structure, that the electron revolve around the nucleus. Maybe in the certain path or maybe not in the certain path, that's a different thing and different theory we're going to discuss. They already revolve around the nucleus and they have two motion. One is about their spin and one is about their nucleus. So how they are going to create a magnetic field? Those two motion is only responsible for magnetic field. So write down the cause of the magnetism. The motion of electron in atoms gives rise to the phenomena called magnetism. So basically the motion of electron is basic cause of the magnetism in the material. Every material have those atoms. Then you must be wondering why not every material showing the magnetism or magnetic field. That we are going to discuss. So basically two types of motion are associated with electrons. First, motion of electron. Please write down this. These are very important thing. The cause of magnetism. Why there is magnetism? So write down the first. The motion of electrons in an object within its nucleus, and second, spin of electron around its axis. So electron is going around the nucleus and revolving around its spin. It is also spinning. Then spinning and orbital movements impact the magnetic movement of each electron, forcing them to behave like as a tiny magnet. Okay, so this is the main cause why there is a magnetic field. Why does not some objects show the magnetic field? This we are going to study, because the classification, the classes of the magnetic material, how they behave at the atomic level and then how they are going to behave at the collective level. That this is only going to define that these materials will show any magnetic effect or magnetic field or not. So now we are going to talk about the magnetic dipole. The magnetic dipole is basically what is the magnetic dipole of the close current carrying loop. What is magnetic dipole of close current loop? It is current into area. Current and area. This magnetic dipole is just like the effect of the magnetic field. how the magnetic field is going to generate in the carrying loop. So basically carrying loop, the magnetic field will be the current into area. What about the charge in circle, the magnetic dipole of the charge in circle? So what we are going to do is the current generated by that charge. So how we are going to find it? The charge divided by the, what is current? What is current? Tell me, what is current? The rate of flow of charge. So charge divided by its time. The time period is taken to revolve or flow. So rate of flow of charge into area. This will be the charge, the magnetic dipole of charge in circle. From the magnetic dipole, we are going to get a torque of the dipole. So what is the torque of the dipole? The torque of the dipole is basically, students, is cross multiplication, or the in the vector what we study, cross multiplication of the magnetic dipole movement with the magnet field. Its unit is joule upon tesla. So basically is it multiply with the area cross section, area cross product to the magnetic field will be resulting in the torque. So if the cross product is the sine theta, so if that magnetic field and area is perpendicular to each other, then sine theta will be 1, and if they are the parallel to each other, then sine theta will be 0. The result of the dipole movement in that field will be 0. And if they are perpendicular, the result of the magnetic movement or torque on the dipole will be maximum. So this is how we are going to define what is a magnetic field and what is a magnetic dipole. And the after multiplication in the magnetic dipole, what we get? The torque on the dipole. The torque in the dipole is joule per tesla. So what, this is the all everything which we're going to study, how the inside the magnetic field. But right now we are interested in only the knowing how the magnetic field created, some why there are the some material which show the magnetic field and why there is some material which does not show the magnetic field. This is the main question and the concern of our in this chapter. So what we are going to study, we are going to study about what is happening in the atomic level. Let's talk about the other subject also. Let's study the physics as a whole. What happen at the atomic level when there is an object, same material, material not changing, temperature is changing. First temperature was 50 degrees Celsius, then temperature was 100 degrees Celsius, then temperature was 200 degrees Celsius. What is the difference if we call the 50 degrees Celsius as a 100 degrees Celsius as a B, and 200 degrees Celsius as C? What is the main difference? Can you tell me what is the main difference at the molecular level, at the atomic level? What is happening? What is happening inside it? So what is happening when we increase the temperature, then the atom start moving very fast. And what you study in the kinetic theory of gases, what you study that when the temperature is increasing, they will collide with the wall in very rapid fashion, then there will be a increase in translation energy. The velocity of electrons will increase, and when the velocity of electron will increase, the energy will increase. So the atoms at the 200 degrees Celsius having the lower or higher energy? Tell me, the 200 is going to have higher energy, or the 50 degrees Celsius having going to have a higher energy? The VRMS, you know, na VRMS in the kinetic theory of gases, you must remember or revise all the things, because you're going to study all the chapter, and if you don't relate all those things, you're going not going to remember about those things. Okay, so what we study in the kinetic theory of gases, that VRMS is directly proportional to temperature. VRMS equal to root of 3 RT by m. So if the temperature of the gas molecule is going to increase, then the velocity of the gas is going to increase. So the translation energy is going to increase. Okay, this is the main purpose. What is happening at the atomic level? We have to study that. And when there is a temperature going to increase, then temperature, the kinetic energy going to increase, and the total energy is also going to increase because it is already the sum of the kinetic energy and the potential energy. Na? Tell me, it is or not? So the total energy of the molecules of the gas is going to increase, student. So that energy is going to increase because we are increasing the temperature, and temperature is increasing the velocity of the electrons, and the velocity of the electron is going to increase the total temperature and the pressure, and the kinetic energy is going to increase, and then the total energy is going to increase, and that increase in energy will happen only because we are increasing the temperature. So now we are going to study about, first we are going to study what is the matter, then we are going to study the effect, the classes of the magnetic material. So already we know that in the modern physics, how we define the matter? By the size, various size of the atoms, we are going to define the matter. How much size is going to atom going to occupy? In the modern physics, write down what is the matter. Let's define it. It will going to take some time, but we have already going to study the effect, the classes of the magnetic field, the magnetic material. Then first we have to study the matter so that we have the whole knowledge of the matter. So write down, in the modern physics, matter is defined as the substance which is made of the various types of particle, various size and matter each. In simple language, what we can say, the substance which has mass and occupies a space is known as matter. Okay, we can call everything as a matter, the table or the copy or the pen from which you are writing on the copy and the ink, everything is a matter. They are in the different state of matter. Like all of you student is matter to me, or the molecule of gas to me. Even we are sitting in the classroom and we all are the molecule. But we having some student is having very great time studying the subject, and some is feeling very sleepy, or like some student is not that energetic because of something they did in their day. So they already, everything is matter. Some is having a great time in the class, some is not having that great time of the class and not interested in study. Those all type of student present in the class. So all type of material is present in the universe, just like class, you know. So everything is in the state of matter. I have different levels, some having a very good temperature, some is having very low temperature, not very enthusiastic about the subject. No, we're going to take care of all those students. No one will be left behind, because everything is very simple if you study in the correct manner and practice all those things in the correct manner. So write down the three state of matter. First, solid. Second, liquid. And third is gas. We are not going to talk about the plasma state. That is the fourth state of the matter. That is not like, we are not studying doing the PhD. Okay, PhD is very good, very, you should do it, but not right now. Right now we have to have a study about all those things which is more important to us from the exam point of view. So what is solid and liquid and gas? So solid is the basic substance in which the definite size and volume. Okay, every matter, every molecule is fixed. That substance is called solid. In the liquid, the indefined shape is there. It can take a shape of any easy container, liquid or gas. Substance which has indefinite size or low density, that is called the gas. So these are the three states of the matter. First, write down the let's write down one, two lines of the each subject, each state solid. The substance which have definite shape and volume, high density and not easily compressible. We already know or we already take in that solid is not compressible. All the solids are not compressible. We already take that assumption. The intermolecular attraction in solid is very strong and it holds the particle of the substance very close. This is why the solid doesn't take a different type of shape. They have a one particular shape. Let down on the liquid. The substance which have indefinite shape is called liquid. Liquid substance has lesser density and lesser intermolecular attraction of force. They are compressible, but we take in the whole physics that if it is not defined, we take that liquid is incompressible, because we take that gas is compressible. With respect to gas, liquid are more denser. So we think, we take in the physics, the liquid are incompressible. Unlike solid, intermolecular attraction is not that high. They are allowed to move from each other because they are going to shape any container in which they are going to put in. What about the gas? The substance which have indefinite shape and has low density are characterized as gaseous substance. So they have even the lesser intermolecular force, and they attract the lesser intermolecular force, so they don't have definite shape even from the point of the liquid, and the forces are very weak compared to the liquid and gas. They are highly compressible. This is very important topic, because we are defining that how the solid, liquid and gas are different from each other. So what is, there are the two, like you should draw the diagram that how the solid and liquid and gas change to each other, that evaporation and condensation. You should write diagram. I am making that diagram on the whiteboard. You should have that diagram. First you made a box. In that box, pack the box with solid particles, because they are very close to each other and the intermolecular forces are very high. So that box will be representing a solid. Then make two other boxes separate two or three fingers from each other. That then the liquid box, they put the molecules little bit closer, but not that far, or not that close at the solid, and not far as the gas. In the gas, but two or three molecules in the box. So in the liquid, intermolecular forces are less than the solid, as we wrote down earlier, and in the gas, liquid intermolecular forces even lesser than the liquid. So how solid is going to take place of the liquid? By melting. When we are going to melt the solid, we are going to get the liquid. And when the liquid is going, when the liquid is heated, then after evaporation, we found the gas. And when the gas condense, it changes back to liquid. And when the liquid freeze, it changes back to solid. This is mainly the cycle of interchangeability from the solid to the gas. So what happened when some solid, like in the we take, there are some example, if you take that some gas at the normal temperature, see, the directly evaporate from solid to gas, that thing is called sublimation. Okay, now we are going to study about the classes of the magnetic material. There is three classes of magnetic material: diamagnetic material, which show the dimagnetism, and the paramagnetic or the ferromagnetic. The few example of the dimagnetic materials are wood, water, gold, mercury, and the paramagnetic, magnesium, lithium, molybdenum is paramagnetic material. And the ferromagnetic materials are the lodestone, elnico. That is the alloy of aluminium, nickel, cobalt and copper. Now we are going to define what is the diamagnetic material. What is the paramagnetic material? What is the ferromagnetic material? So in the diamagnetic material, first let's understand what is diamagnetic material. The wood, water and copper and gold are diamagnetic material. But why? You should always ask this question to yourself. Why? Why this thing is happening? Then you only get the answer. Just don't take everything as written in the textbook. You should ask this question to yourself. You should have that courage to answer your own doubt. And if you're not able to understand the concept from yourself, then only you should consult or you should approach the tutor or approach me, because we can easily go give you the answer, but that answer is not going to be beneficial for you, is it? Nah? Because you, in the end, you have to learn all those things. So let's get back on the topic. Okay, study hard and ask doubt to yourself. Okay, do that and you will be a very good student and very good human. So let's study about the diamagnetic material. What is happening at the atomic level and the diamagnetic material is that diamagnetic material, if we take the few electrons of diamagnetic material and talk about the electrons, how the electron is behaving, because we already talked about that why there is a magnetic field. Every material is having the magnetic field at the atomic level, but why some material, only some few material show the magnetic field and other don't? Why that is happening? So first we are going to study at atomic level. The electron is revolving around the nucleus and it is spinning about its axis. So the atoms is having the magnetic field. All, if we take only 3 or 5 atoms, and though 3 or 5 atoms, every atom is going to have electrons. Every electrons, like if you take 5 electrons from 5 different atoms, they are going to have a magnetic field. But what is what happen in diamagnetic material, that diamagnetic material has the magnetic field at the atomic level. Okay, when they have a field at atomic level because of the charge particle revolving around the nucleus and about its spin, but the total magnetic the diamagnetic material, total magnetic field of all electron cancel each other. The dipole moment of M1, M2, M3 or M4, M5 is zero. So the total magnetic field of all those atoms will be zero. In diatomic substance, the total magnetic field is zero because all electrons in the atoms cancelled magnetic field of each other. Okay, the atoms have the electrons, and these electrons have the magnetic field. When we combine the magnetic moment of all the electrons, those magnetic dipole cancel each other. So because of that, one individual atom have the magnetic field, the total, all the atoms, total atom doesn't have magnetic field. So magnetic field of the substance is not there. So write the definition of the diamagnetic. Those materials which are less susceptible to magnetic fields are called diamagnetic material. They exhibit property of diamagnetism, whereby the net magnetic moment of atom, the net magnetic moment, individual electrons are showing the magnetic field. The net magnetic moment of the atom is zero. Thus, when placed in the magnetic field, it produces negative magnetism. Negative means zero magnetism. Example, the most basic example is water and the wood. So this happen in the diamagnetic material. What is different in the paramagnetic material? In the paramagnetic material, all the electrons' magnetic field does not cancel each other. So total dipole moment of atom is not zero. So the atom exhibit the magnetic field. Because of that, all the atoms exhibit a magnetic field. And why those all the atoms exhibited by the magnetic field? Because the magnetic field. So student, total dipole moment in the atom is not zero because all the electrons magnetic field does not cancel each other. The dipole is the vector. That's why the direction and the magnitude, all those things matter. In the what happens in the dimagnetic, the inside the atom, all the electrons cancel each other magnetic field or magnetic dipole. That's why the atom was not able to show the magnetic characteristics. But in the paramagnetic, so student, in the paramagnetic material, there will be magnetic fields of the atoms. The magnetic fields of atom exist, display of the atoms, dipoles of the atoms in the all the direction. The atoms is existing the dipole moment, and the same dipole moment is a vector quantity. So the vector that all the atoms are in the random fashion, just like we study in the kinetic theory of gases, that all the atoms are in the random motion and performing the Brownian motion, the main characteristics of the kinetic theory of the gases. So the randomly added all the dipole moments of the atoms. So all the in the orientation is random. So if the orientation is random, then the resultant of the all the vector will be zero. As you study in the vector, the first chapter in the vector, that if we are going to combine one vector to other vector and the whole the vector is going to form a closed loop, then that loop is going to have a resultant of zero magnitude. So no magnetic field of substance, because the substance is going to have all the atoms in it, and all the atoms is having going to have dipole movements, and dipole movement is a vector. So the vector quantity in the randomly distributed fashion is going to have a zero resultant, no dipole moment of the substance. When there is going to have a zero dipole moment of the substance, then the material will not show the magnetic property. Why their material, the diamagnetic and the paramagnetic having a different reason to not showing the magnetic characteristics. The diamagnetic doesn't show the magnetic characteristics because the electrons in the atoms was cancelled the dipole moment of each other. In this, the paramagnetic, the electrons in the atom is not going to cancel the magnetic field of each other, but the dipole moments of the atoms to other atom, the dipole moment of the atom is going to add in the vector fashion, and that vector resultant will be zero because all the atoms in the moving in the random fashion, that is called the Brownian motion, what we already study in the kinetic theory of the gases. So all the electrons atom do not cancel, the total moment is zero, not zero of the atoms in the paramagnetic, it's zero in the diamagnetic. Particle in the paramagnetic substance has an individual magnetic field, but dipole movements of the all the particles are added in the randomly oriented fashion. So the net magnetic field will be zero. Write down the definition of the paramagnetic material. The best example of the paramagnetic material is aluminium, platinum, due to partial filled orbital. Now we are going to discuss all the things in the chemistry. You should be very careful. So due to the partial filled orbital, some atom possess the net magnetic moment, resulting in the positive magnetism and susceptibility in the presence of magnetic field. But when the field is removed, the magnetism is zero. That example is magnesium and molybdenum. So what is happening? The net magnetic field of the substance without any external disturbance in the diamagnetic and the paramagnetic is zero. Okay, there's no doubt in this, both are zero. But what happens when we place a paramagnetic material in the external magnetic field? All those dipoles which were randomly oriented will be aligned in the direction of the magnetic field. This is a very important concept. This alignment will cause the dipole moment to get along and give the torque according to magnetic dipole cross product magnetic field. This will get the dipole and this will get the magnetic moment, because the external field will get external field will create an effect on the dipole moment. So those dipole moment will be getting in the one direction, and because all of those dipole will be having a dipole moment in the one direction, so the no magnetic field will have a effect on it. The magnetic field external to substance is aligning the dipole moment. But if we remove, now this is happening a dipole moment and magnetic moment. But if we remove the magnetic field, what will happen? What do you think will be going to happen? Will this going to sustain the magnetic field, or it is going to not sustaining the magnetic field? It is not going to sustain magnetic field, student. You have to understand, the external agent is responsible for aligning the dipole moment in the one direction. And all those atoms does not have a characteristics to be in the one fashion. Just like in the class, when I am the class or every student is focused on the whiteboard. Okay, like I am the magnetic external magnetic field for you all. If you all are the dipole moments and I am the magnetic field, I am the external magnetic field and you all are aligned in the one direction. Okay, if I am not in the class, somebody will talk to each other, somebody will use their phone, somebody will sleep, somebody do anything. So resultant of the all the dipole movement, if you all are the dipole movement in the class, when I am in the class, is zero. Same is going to happen in the paramagnetic material. If you were that disciplined, that even if I am not in the class and you are aligned in the one direction to study and working hard and learning things, then that thing will be ferromagnetic material. Now we are going to study the most important class of the magnetic material, that is the ferromagnetic material. What is the ferromagnetic material? So you are clear with the diamagnetic, paramagnetic, the basic difference. Resultant magnetic field is not there, but in the paramagnetic, if we induce magnetic field, then there will be alignment in the dipole. That is paramagnetic. The example is magnesium and molybdenum. Okay, now we are going to study ferromagnetic material. The ferromagnetic material, if we compare with the diamagnetic and paramagnetic material, are having a different concept. The ferro, a single magnetic field, single atom has a magnetic field and net magnetic field of the all the atoms, because like if you study the kinetic theory of gases, or you know that we assume that every molecule, every material have randomly distributed atoms. The dipole moments will always be in the random fashion, so we cannot have a aligned dipole movements without any external object. So the net magnetic field of all the object will be zero even in the ferromagnetic material. This may be very shocking to you that in the magnetic field of the ferromagnetic material is also going to zero. The vector addition will going to be zero, because we are going to add randomly fashion. We going to add in the random fashion. It will going to have zero resultant because of the vector law of polygon. Okay, vector law of polygon, because we are going to add all the dipole moment in the polygons, and that polygon, if that polygon is closed, because there is a Na number of atoms in the molecule. Na, one mole of atoms is going to have Na number of
molecules in them. Na is Avogadro number. What is the value? What is the order of the Na? 10^23. So we can always say the vector addition will be going to zero. But now you have to pay more attention, because now this differ with the parametric material. How they going to differ? The difference with parametric substance in after field is applied. After field is applied in the parametric, it also shows the alignment of the dipole moment. Ferromagnetic material is also going to show the alignment with the magnetic material. But what is going to happen? The total dipole moment is very high and the magnetic field is very high in the ferromagnetic. This is not going to happen in the paramagnetic material, but this paramagnetic field and the total dipole moment is going to very high. So the torque generated by dipole moment and the magnetic field is going to very high in the ferromagnetic material. This is main difference. And after this, we also classify ferromagnetic material in a two classes. One is soft ferromagnetic material, other is hard ferromagnetic material. So in these two classification, those are all those soft ferromagnetic material and hard ferromagnetic material, those are ferromagnetic material. In the soft ferromagnetic material, after we going to remove or break the magnetic field, the alignment break after removing the magnetic field, okay, the alignment break, the alignment will not be sustaining, as I said, because even in the ferromagnetic material, all those material is going to have some effect. And the classification in which some material is called soft ferromagnetic material is not going to have the magnetic field after that broke down, or they're going to have very, very meager, very, very small value of magnetic field or dipole moments after the breaking of the external magnetic field. Okay, so this will be very disheartening to many persons, but let's come to the second winner of our discussion, hard ferromagnetic substance. The hard ferromagnetic substance, after removing the magnetic field, the alignment does not break. Okay, the alignment does not break. It's sustained. And if the alignment sustained, the magnetic field will be created from that material. First, in natural state, because of the random motion, it wasn't there. Was it? The magnetic field wasn't there because of dipole moment addition in the vector fashion. Will be zero, because all the atoms are randomly distributed, so it will be zero. Okay, but after removing the applied external magnetic field, once the dipoles was aligned, the hard ferromagnetic material sustained that discipline. Like if all the students in the class want to do well and do work hard, so even if I'm not in the class, then also they're going to study, they work hard. Okay, there's no, the discipline is the first thing which you should have in yourself, not forced by anybody. It is induced characteristics, it's not force. The forcing is something which we have to do because you're not understanding that thing. A thing which you should have for your family, for your friends, for you, the most of it for you. You should learn all those things by yourself. Okay, you must try to discipline yourself by yourself, because if not, you're not going to have any success. The potential you have, everybody have a very good potential, but you have to have discipline, just like a hard ferromagnetic substance. Okay, after removing the magnetic field in the hard ferromagnetic substance, the magnetic field sustained. The strong alignment of the dipole moment, so the magnetic field sustained. In the old times, what we used to do that in the 90s and 80s, even in the father's times, that we used to have an iron rod, and that iron rod was kept between the magnets for a long time. And after removing the iron rod after 1 or 2 years, that iron rod was also performing like a magnet. Why it is? Because that material is a hard ferromagnetic material substance. So example of Alnico. Alnico is an alloy of nickel, aluminium, cobalt and copper and lodestone. These are the permanent magnet. We call these as the permanent magnet. The alignment of a dipole will sustain. The soft ferromagnetic material is also used in some contest, because in the some machine we also use temporary, like in the crane we want to use temporary magnetic material. So we use soft ferromagnetic material there. So after that, let us write down the ferromagnetism. Unlike die magnets and paramagnets, those material which tend to remain magnetized even when the magnetic field is removed exhibits ferromagnetism. This phenomena is also known as hysteresis. The plot between variation of magnetism with the magnetic field is called hysteresis loop. However, at one point or temperature, the ferromagnetic material tend to lose its magnetic property. This temperature or a point is called Curie point or Curie temperature. So now we are going to also, you should also look on the hysteresis cycle. The hysteresis loop is shown in the figure. You can also look in the notes. The hysteresis graph is already there. We start at the applied magnetic field. The dipole movements is in the haphazard manner, in the random manner, you can say. Then we applied the magnetic field and they went in the manner. Material magnetized to saturated by alignment of the domain. Domain effects is, we're going to study domain effect also. So when diving magnetic field drops to zero, the ferromagnetic materials retain a considerable amount of degree of magnetization. This is useful as a magnetic memory device. Okay, the driving magnetic field must be reversed and increased to large value or to drive magnetism to the zero, the other end of the hysteresis. Okay, the hysteresis loop show that the history dependent nature of magnetism of the ferromagnetic material. But if it is having, it already gets saturated, then it is also going to remember all those direction or domain. So let's first study the Curie temperature, then the domain effect, then if we get the time, we also going to study the hysteresis graph. So what is the Curie temperature? At high temperature, the alignment of the ferromagnetic substance break due to thermal energy. Because look, everything is made up of the atom. Everything, even you, your finger, your pen and the pencil, all the living and non-living things are made of atoms. And those atoms made the dipole moment. And if we increase the value of temperature, then the kinetic energy, which with molecules are vibrating or moving, will going to increase. So there must be a temperature in which the dipole moment attraction is going, like it going to cancelled by the thermal energy or by the attraction force of the temperature. So the temperature at which this happen, the thermal energy exceed the alignment of the ferromagnetic substance, that temperature is called the Curie temperature. At before the Curie temperature, it behave like a hard ferromagnetic material. But after the Curie temperature, it behaves like a paramagnetic substance. Okay? At that temperature, it behaves like a paramagnetic substance. Now we are going to study classes of the magnetic material on the basis of domain theory of the ferromagnetism. Till now we are talking about the dipole moments and the electron. Now we are going to look with the respect of a domain. Just a way to understand ferromagnetism in a better way. There is always going to have a perspective, nazariya. You already have a perspective of your parents And from their perspective, you are going to think this is not going to right, this is wrong, I want this, I want that, from your perspective. But from if you look from their perspective, you must do this. Everything the parents say is good. You should listen to your parents and follow their instruction. Okay? Not because they are parents, because they know many things which is real, which is going to help you in your life. Okay? Let's effect a domain effect. What the domain is collective of some atoms in a smaller domain. Okay, the collection of some atoms together is called domain. That domain is going to have a dipole movement resultant of those atoms. Domain direction depends on the all the atoms in the domain. All domains are random, so vector addition will be zero in any atoms. If we apply the magnetic field just like applied in the paramagnetic, the domain will be merging other domain and making the bigger domain. So the bigger domain, the bigger will be from bigger will be the magnetic field. All the lines will be going to have a denser. We are going to have denser line if the magnetic field is high. So student, what we study, now we are going to running out of time and we are going to study hysteresis loop in the next class. What we study in this class, let's revise everything what we study, because revision is very important. Without revision, you will not be remembering anything. You will be clean slate. Okay, you will be just like you came in this class right now. So revision of the class, what we revise in the, what we study in the class is basically what is magnet. What magnet has and classification of matter and classes of magnetic material. So and the QE temperature also and the domain theory also. The relationship between the matter and the magnetism. The role of force existing between the particle within substance determining how the substance will behave when placed in the magnetic field. This is what we study right now in the whole lecture. Normally, every substance possess magnetic characteristics. Yeah. Substance like aluminium and copper will consider the high magnetic property is also affected when placed in the magnetic field. No. Depending on the response of their behavior, it's either repulsion or attraction. Materials are classified as a paramagnetic or diamagnetic or ferromagnetic. So the conclusion of the chapter, we should also conclude our classes. The magnetism is a very common and very important phenomena which find in every field. In physics, magnetism helps to understand the behavior of the property of the matter. Okay, the way a matter respond when placed in the magnetic field give rise to different type of magnetic material. It is paramagnetic, diamagnetic and ferromagnetic. Thus, we can conclude that matter and magnetism are closely related to each other. Thank you very much. Learn as much as you can and work hard. Good night.